Hello, it's Leontine from Little Lovely Crafts. Today's card is all about sentiments and all about bees, because when you open the card, you'll see there's a little beehive hidden in there. Something I learned from my previous card is that I need to score everything before I assemble it, because it's going to get folded inside of an interactive card. I will be using the center picture window dies in a different way. My center picture window dies will become a beehive, and one of the bees is going to sort of like look from the entrance of the beehive, and that is why I need to make sure that all of the parts that I'm using are already scored and folded before I can assemble everything with glue. The cardstock that I'm using is from Lawn Fawn. It's sunflower cardstock with black licorice, and I'm using ballet slippers on his cheeks and some vellum for the wings. I wanted to give my bee some legs so that he's kind of like placing his legs outside of the entrance of the beehive, and I used the cheeks from the Woodland Critter Huggers for it. You see me gluing it on here, but later I peeled them off again because I needed to glue them on the outside of the beehive instead of directly on his body. With my white gel pen, I'm making some accents on his eyes, and then I am attaching the wings, and once the wings are attached, I can put some glossy accents on his eyes. One of the last steps for this bee is putting some glitter on his wings to give it a nice accent. You could of course also use the pearlescent vellum, but I wanted to use the regular vellum. Once that's dry, you need to fold it back into shape because it tends to curl up a little bit. I use number 2 pencil for the reversed stitched scallop rectangle windows, that's a mouthful, and I also used the number 2 pencil cardstock on the sentiments and black licorice as well, because I want to offset them a little bit. I die cut happy and I die cut birthday, but I'm going to alter the birthday because it's too long and I wanted to say B day, because then you say B and that seems to fit with the card. I'm using my scissors to alter the B and D, and as for the dash that's going to be between the B and D, I'm using a little piece of the H. That finishes off the sentiment. Now I'm going to work on making some flowers. I decided that the wings from the Tiny Gift Box bee add-on would be perfect flower petals. So I die cut them a few times, and I die cut the little yellow circle from the circle that came in the 4-square backdrop portrait. I'm using my Copic sketch marker V15 to make the flower petals a little more interesting. All I'm doing is just flicking the marker a little bit and just creating some lines there that you might see on a real flower petal as well. You might have noticed I had some Distress Oxide inks laying there on my glass media mat. I thought I was going to use those, but it didn't work out as well as I thought, so the marker did a better job and I went with the marker. I'm using my rectangle window to constantly check if my placement is alright or if I need to move it a little bit, and I keep doing that until everything is glued down. I just don't want there to be a gap and another color cardstock peeking through. I tried a few colors for the background of my front panel and decided that the mermaid cardstock had the best tone to bring out the yellows and the purples of my card, so I cut a piece that matches with the rectangle window. And now for the beehive part, I'm using the Watercolor Wishes paper pack, the 6x6 one, and this color just reminded me of honey for some reason, so I thought it would be cool to use it on the beehive. Because I want my card to be taller than the regular center picture window, I am altering how I die cut it. I am placing it on the edge of my cutting plates, and that way I can use the die again and create a higher window. You'll see me doing it on video, and then you can follow exactly if you want to recreate something like this as well. If you put the dies back on the paper after you die cut it the first time, you can kind of feel it with the edges of your die where the first cuts are, and then align it as good as you can to get a straight cut. Mine was a tiny little bit off center, but it didn't matter because they are going to be the glue tabs. You can always just trim it off a little bit with your scissors, and when you're going to fold it, you can always use your bone folder to get a nice crisp fold. And then you can cut the oval out of the paper. Once that is done, I got out another one of those Watercolor Wishes papers because it's going to be the inside of the beehive, so it's going behind my center picture window, and I am measuring how wide it should be, and I'm using my cutting and scoring board to cut it and score it right down the middle. I want it to look like my beehive is hanging in a tree, so I'm getting out some Spiffy Speckles 12x12 paper, and I will be using the Puffy Cloud Borders to recreate a full leafy tree. I'm really hoping that Lawn Farm will release some slimline additions this fall-winter release, so that I don't have to cut things twice like I'm doing right now. I have to go back in with the cloud to finish the whole leafy tree pattern. Like I did with the center picture window dies, I'm feeling where the previous cutting lines are to get a nice finished edge. want the inside of my card to have the same mermaid blue color as the outside of my card, but I'm not going to use mermaid cardstock, and I just thought, why not use merman ink, and then I can recreate the same blue color. My little sponge came off, so I had to get another one. I thought it was a new one, but it turned out it had some Yeti ink on there. That's why my ink cube is getting a little white. I die cut two cloud pieces or leafy tree pieces, but I only ended up using one. And the piece that I have right now is just a long strip, but I'm going to cut it up so that my card can open and close a lot more easily. All you have to do is just measure it with that beehive panel, and then you can cut it at the desired length. I'm assembling the card now, and I was using tape runner on the little backer piece for my beehive, but the tape runner came off when I opened and closed my card, so I decided to put some liquid glue on top, and that seemed to hold a lot better. The inside of my card is pretty much finished, but I ended up using another B on the left panel, and I used the Bzz stamp from the Say What Spring Critters. Now that I am all done with the inside and I know that I am happy with the color scheme, I can attach everything on the front of the card. I'm using a little binder clip I bought at Staples a few years ago to hold the card together because it's easier to see where I'm assembling everything when the card is laying flat. I put some glue dots behind the bee on the front of my card to lift him up a little bit from the flowers. On the inside of my card, I'm using the stamp I mentioned earlier, the Bzz from the Say What Spring Critters, and I'm adding another bee, but I can't stamp the sentiment there yet because his eyes are still wet, but you can see how it turned out in the pictures. I like making bee-themed things because my classroom has a bee theme as well, and I think this card turned out really cute. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. And if you click the notification bell, you will know when my next video is online. Thank you so much again and have a wonderful day. See you next time. Bye.